The hospital was built at a cost of 118 billion shillings, of which the government of Uganda contributed 20%, and it's situated on a 30-acre piece of land. President Yoweri Museveni noted that the facility has a number of interesting aspects, including the founder being a wonderful Christian with the concept of caring about others. He also suggested that they can have a nursing training school near this hospital to encourage skills development.
Really very happy to be here. And the permanent secretary has brought another idea of the nursing training center, which could be part of this, because we have to think about that, how to partner with our friends, these devoted people from Italy, mixing Christianity with communism, with all that.
The hospital will become a referral point for surgery for patients from all over the continent. It is the second facility in Emergencies African Network of Medical Excellence after Emergencies Salam Center for Cardiac Surgery, built in Khartoum, Sudan in 2007, which has treated patients from over 30 countries. Situated on the banks of Lake Victoria, Emergencies Children's Surgical Hospital opened its doors on Monday, the 19th of April this year. But due to COVID-19 restrictions, the opening ceremony took place today after 6 months of activities. The facility has admitted 345 patients since opening, while 1,185 patients have been treated as outpatients. 355 surgical operations have taken place, and the average patient age is 5 years.
The land, that one was not so difficult, because our special forces, we are looking after cattle here. They had quite some land here. They were using it as a cattle farm. So when I heard of a hospital for free treatment for children, I thought it was more important than looking after cows. So I said, okay, you people give us 30 acres. You can go and look after cows in Changwanzi, Chivoga. There are other places where you can go and look after cows. But here, let us use this center for this life-saving effort.
Rosella Michio, the president of this facility, says the hospital is rapidly becoming a referral point for pediatric elective surgery in Uganda and beyond, as they are receiving patients from around the country and will soon open their doors to provide free-of-charge surgical care to children from neighboring countries. At full capacity, the hospital will employ 385 local people, including 179 medical workers.
It was meant to be an international referral center for pediatric surgery, for elective pediatric surgery. Of course, this is done in different steps. So initially we want to establish the facility and look after the Ugandan patient, and then to open it hopefully in the coming months to the neighboring countries and beyond. The model is what we have already been doing in Sudan, where we have treated patients from over 30 countries. Of course, the pandemic had an impact on our clinical activities, both internally because of the problems in moving among the different districts, and of course in terms of international reach out.
The facility will be dedicated to training local staff who will play an integral role in improving pediatric surgery. The Minister for Health, Dr. Jane Ruth Acheng, said the facility cost the government 118 billion shillings. The Uganda government contributed 20% and will continue paying 20% of the running costs for 8 years until it is handed over to the Ugandan government.
Our major donor, Paula, who is here today, contributed $8 million for this facility. And government of Uganda, covered 20% of the entire costs. The government of Uganda also continues to provide 20% of operational costs of this hospital and will do so for the next 8 years when the hospital will be handed over to us.
Dr. Gino Strada, an Italian war surgeon, human rights and peace activist and founder of this hospital, died in August this year before the official commissioning of the hospital that he was looking forward to. Report by Shamshad Naluja for the news in Entebbe.